sometimes you like to criticize mistakes. Let's criticize some great playmaking here, too. Up against the boards, a battle is lost. One of the few against the boards is Mealy is checked, poked away, and Mullen then sets up the play for John Tonelli. Now, he appears to be covered enough, but, you know, you never let John Tonelli get too much room on you. And he got just a little bit more than the Canadians would like, and he scored the only goal of the period. That made it 1-0. Good snapshot. You can say that he got a jump on Gaston Chingrois. You can say also that Patrick Roy perhaps didn't cover the angle as well as he should. Let's give credit also where it's due. John Tonelli scored on a great effort.
And here we go with the second period. Puck shot in by Montreal. Canadians are shorthanded as this period begins, and here is a break. Reinhardt in. By Nyla. And Calgary's McInnes cleared it up. Carried back in by Gingras. Gingras moving in. Shoots. He scores! Gaston Gingras puts the Calgary lead to 2-1.
Well, there's Gaston into his Alphonse and Gaston act here. As he got his circle to the fence. Eve's trying to check on him, but they seem to... Well, he just overskated him. She made a mistake, and then his own man, Reinhardt, cleared.
Shot the center, and Chelios has it there. Chelios to Carbonell. Has Mealy with him. Pass to Mealy. Scores! Dave Mealy, the rookie, ties this game up.
Wonder if he played soccer sometime during his lifetime, Brad. He played it through off his skate beautifully.
He did handle the puck well, but Cardinal held the puck and held the puck. Watched the defenseman go to the right. He put it back off the skates. A chip. It goes off Bruin's pad and up into the net. Cardinal made the only pass that he could make here. He had to put it there. And Mealy did a great job of taking it off the skates.
That's an art. There are a lot of players in the National Hockey League who can't do that. David Mealy from the University of Wisconsin, another Badger. He was recruited by
there for Chelios. Chelios around McInnes. Chelios tied up by Bartel. Now dropping to Robinson. We're in the final minute of regulation. Montreal Nyland centered. Bartel there to clear it. And he got it by Chelios, and Robinson has to hustle back. 48 seconds left in regulation time. Shot to center. Back comes McCallum. Moving in, Robinson checked in. 40 seconds left. Larry Robinson to Chris Chelios. Dumped it in, Reinhardt knocked it down. Calgary trying to break back, but Strudlin broke it up. Now Robinson to McPhee. McPhee getting it to Strudlin. 20 seconds left in regulation. Strudlin dumping it in. Vernon cleared it, knocked down by Lemieux. McCowan trying to clear it. Knocked behind the net with 10 seconds left. Lanny McDonald ducks under a check. McCowan for Calgary. Getting it to Quinn. Shot to center. Green has it there. Shoots it back in, and we will have sudden death overtime to decide game two here in Calgary. After regulation, the teams are tied at two in quite a hockey game.
The Canadians have had all kinds of scoring chances. They haven't scored. Now a break in overtime. Windsor and the Flames, if you're looking for a team that has a good chance to escape with something, they are in that position right now.
Shots on goal favored Montreal 34-22. Sudden death overtime coming up. The Stanley Cup Final live from Calgary.
To that question about, are you nervous at this point in sudden death? Because somebody told me in an earlier playoff game, they're so tired and they're so busy trying to get ready for the overtime, you don't really get nervous.
You don't, but you do. Everybody has that moment just to sit by themselves and think about it, and that anticipation can get pretty scary.
I know you scored a big overtime goal against Buffalo. Was that your only overtime playoff goal?
It was the only one that I ever got, and it was the seventh game in overtime, and if you've got to get one, that was the best time to get one.
Well, you're one ahead of Roos and Kelly.
Absolutely, and this one, a very important overtime for the Montreal Canadiens especially. They don't want to be going home down 2-0 in this series. But the home ice advantage in this series, and the Canadiens came in here looking mostly for a split in the opening two games, send it back to Montreal, make it a best of five series with the Montreal Canadiens holding the home ice advantage through those final five. So here we go to overtime, a lot on the line between these two hockey clubs.
The big shooters in this game, by the way, with five shots apiece, have been Gingras, Gainey for Montreal. The big shooter for Calgary, Reinhart, who's had four shots. Here we go. Sudden death overtime, game two. Stanley Cup Final, 1986. Montreal break in. McPhee has a man open. They score! The Canadiens, right off the bat at the nine-second mark, score to take the win and tie the series at one game apiece. 9 seconds only it took.
Brian Skrudland got the goal. Watch it, right off the faceoff. This is a two-on-one. How could this happen this early in overtime? Suddenly, McPhee's over the line with Skrudland. Great pass and a chip shot. Brennan wasn't expecting the pass at all. Goodness, what an immense mistake. It appeared that the Flames just weren't ready.
Two mistakes here, Ron. Keenan McCallum moves up here. The puck bounces by him. Now as the puck comes back, Montreal moves in. Watch the defenseman go over to block the shot, which the goaltender is already playing, and it gets redirected by Skrulin into the net. It was a bing-bang play, a pretty goal, and if you've got to get an overtime goal, you'd rather have it be something like that than a trickle.
There it is. It's all over in the series, all even at one apiece.
Only 9 seconds of overtime before the Canadiens win it on the goal by Skrudland. And it is a 3-2 victory. This series is tied at one game apiece as it goes back to Montreal.
And this could be a